Live from the Delta Center in Salt Lake City, Utah, it's International Hockey League action with the Cincinnati Cyclones and the Western Conference Salt Lake Golden Eagles. Good evening, everybody. I'm Mike Barrick, and welcome to another edition of Salt Lake Golden Eagles Hockey.
And a break now for Strouch in the Admiral zone. Shorthanded, it'll go shoot. Stoller pop to save, he scores! Rich Turnavis! And the Golden Eagles, a shorthanded goal. They lead 1-0.
Here's the play across the line. McNeil in on goal. Tied up. Eagles break back. 2-on-2. Wow. Chernomaz in with the forward Gillingham. Chernomaz for Gillingham. Right side LeBeau. He scores! Patrick LeBeau on the backhand. 6:51 to go. Third period. Salt Lake 2 and Milwaukee 1.
DeForsman cuts in. Shoots. Stick save. Rebound. Forsman. He scores! Thomas Forsman on the rebound. And with 8:41 to go in the second, the Eagles strike to cut it to 2-1. On a snapshot, rebound, down low.
And now LeBeau scampers into the blade zone, cuts in the slot, now in on goal, fires, Flaherty a pad save, loose in front, LeBeau a chance, tipped away. Now McCarthy a shot, he scores! Sandy McCarthy, after the Eagles had three cracks into the Kansas City zone. 7:49 gone into the opening period. The Eagles strike to tie the game, it's a 1-1 standoff.
Eagles hold it in, Strouch shoots, blocker save Gilmore, rebound in front of the goal and squirts wide, and Phoenix take over. Great scoring chances for Salt Lake, and McCaughey for Phoenix, in across the line, but Chris Miller stands him up, and great plays on both ends of the ice.
Now Salt Lake, Strouch back of the net for Gillingham. Here's Todd Gillingham, front of center one, blocked off at the last moment, and the Jacks hold on. 5 minutes gone. Into the first, and here we have another scrap for the run of the goal. It is Gillingham, and also Paul Rouse, the leading penalty player for the Jacks, and Rouse falls on top, and that sends a rise to the crowd, and the linesman in to separate at the point. Sabrin shoots, blocker, save, rebound. Oh, and they cleared right through the goal crease, and wide. Portman, his shot going wide. Eagles trying to center one for McCarthy. 17 seconds left. Chernomaz now back of the goal, trying to work it in front. LeBeau centers. Hafey scores! Sean Hafey with 11 seconds to go in the game. It is a 4-3 Cleveland lead. Held in by Milwaukee. Eagles, however, control. Melrose with an empty net. Down the left wing side. In on goal. Shoots! And that's blocked away. Rebound. Both fires wide. And Milwaukee played with 26 seconds left. A six attacker situation in an empty net. 20 seconds left. Here's a chance in front. Treffler off the save.
Here's Hafey across the line. Works in against the defense. Cuts it on net. Stops. Scores! Sean Hafey on a beautiful individual effort.
Chernomaz in across the line. A reach shot. Galupo kicks it aside. Werman a shot. That's tipped away. That 2-on-0 breakaway for Cincinnati. Wallace and Holland. Wallace for Holland. He scores! Dennis Holland on a 2-on-0. And with 10:09 left, the Cyclones lead 6-4. Here's the play on left wing. Phoenix take over. It's flipped high in the air. Got down to the defense by Wertman. There's but not out. Chapdelain holds it in. 13 seconds left. Roadrunner's trying to center one, but the Eagles break back on left wing, and Struby leads Harris. Hafey now to cross the line. In. Shoots. He scores! Sean Hafey with 2 seconds left in the game. Take a look at the starting goal center tonight for Salt Lake, Trevor Kidd. He's 20 years of age, 27 games, and a mark of 10-15-1, a 3.93 goals against average. And looking for his first victory against the Lumberjacks, of course, in the very first meeting between the two teams. And his opponent tonight is Rob Dobson. He's 25 years of age, was terrific last season against Salt Lake, 17-8-3, a 3.30 goals against, and that is sixth in the IHL in GAA. Hey, let's take a look at the starters tonight. First for the Golden Eagles and also for the Lumberjacks. Paul Cruz on the wing with Tim Harris, Sean Hafey up the middle, and as mentioned, Trevor Kidd in goal with Wertman and Sabrin on defense. Gauthier, Dubier, and also McCulloch is the big line for Cleveland. David St. Pierre, Alex Nikoluk, Chris Miller, and Thomas Forsland scratch for Salt Lake. Greg Andrusuk and Jason Smart for the Lumberjacks. Is that Forsland was called up to the current Calgary Flames and will be in action this weekend. The referee tonight is Dan O'Halloran, the linesman Russ Johnson and Jim Hanneberg, and we're underway here in Richfield, Ohio. The first ever meeting between the Eagles and the Cleveland Lumberjacks, formerly known as the Muskegon Lumberjacks. And back there for Kevin Wortman on the left wing side for Paul Cruz as we're early on here in the first period. And Cruz able to swivel into the Cleveland zone. Works in against the defense front and center one. Now Harris back with the goal for Salt Lake. He is crashed from the boards on left wing. And then won by Cleveland all the way down deep into the Salt Lake zone. Sandgren and the forward for the Lumberjacks. And that being Justin Duberman after it. Finally, it's cleared but not out. Held into the left wing point by Gauthier and steered aside. Here's Mikhailik trying to set him on does. They score, and it only takes a total of 46 seconds. Todd Nelson from his left defense position came working inside the blue line, and Dave Perekasy, it's a 1-0 Cleveland lead.
Excellent pass by Dave Mikhailik, because he just didn't even look. Just threw it back into the slot, knowing that Nelson would cruise into the opening. As Mikhailik jumps on that rebound off the boards, and he just backhands it right out, right between Sean Hafey's legs, and Nelson just fires it in right between the legs of Trevor Kidd in goal.
Well, Todd Nelson scores the goal, and he is a defenseman. His third goal of the year. Dave Mikhailik and also Daniel Gauthier on the assists, and a 1-0 Cleveland lead. And again, it takes only 46 seconds here into the first period. The Eagles, who lost in Kansas City Wednesday night, find themselves down here tonight as well. And immediately Sully cleared into the Cleveland zone. Here's Harkins front of center one, but the Jacks are able to break it up on right wing. And up the middle it goes for the forward. Perry Gantcher is swung off at the last moment by Paul Holden, and here come the Eagles back. Patrick LeBeau, second of the IHL in scoring, to poke check at the defense and covering up Jamie Heward on left wing. A pass ahead across the line for Sandy Smith, poke check, and cleared by Solik all the way down into the Cleveland zone. Early on, first period, a 1-0 lead in favor of the Lumberjacks. Paul Holden after icing is the call. 1:33 gone, first period, and already a Cleveland lead of 1-0. Paul Holden, who did not play Wednesday night, back in the lineup for Salt Lake. The Eagles lost a 4-3. Well, actually, it was 5-4 in an overtime game Wednesday night against Kansas City. Bob Francis disheartened about that.
Well, talking to Bobby a little this morning, very concerned over the officiating in Kansas City. Is a very tough call, very questionable call on an offside play late in the game that resulted in that winning goal.
Faceoff will be deeper to the Cleveland zone. Eagles win the draw. Wortman shoots and a kick save by Dobson. The rebound cuts in the fronting as a Clark is shot. But also blocked off the defense. Solik in a forechecks. Krush captured for the Golden Eagles. Juan Frey into center. And the Eagles gain possession, but back of the play, a stop. And Dan O'Halloran, I believe, is going to call a holding penalty. 1-0 in favor of Cleveland here early in the first period. And this is Solik Golden Eagles hockey. Todd Gillingham, 2 minutes for holding at 1:49, and Cleveland will go on the power play. The Jacks rank 11th in the IHL in power play percentage, going 54 for 304, 17%. As Todd Gillingham, 2 more minutes for him, a total of 192, Dave, this season.
Todd Gillingham doing an excellent job in front of the Lumberjack zone, trying to jump on a loose rebound. David Struch, Kerry Clark, really playing very well at this time of the season.
Faceoff will be into the neutral zone, and Tom Prost and David Struch as the forwards up front to kill it off on defense on the Salt Lake Golden Eagles, Wortman and Stoke. And as mentioned earlier, the Jacks 11th in the league in the power play percentage, and so they've been fairly poor in that. The Eagles penalty killing pretty good. They've had more power play chances against than any other team in the IHL. And here the Jacks clearing it right back into the Salt Lake zone. It's a wild free in the center. And Cleveland just cleared right back deep into Salt Lake territory. The puck is cleared now into the slot. A chance for Cleveland. And the save made by Kidd on Jason Duberman in front of the goal. Here the Eagles trying to work it free. And finally Stoke able to cue it off the boards all the way down. And Dobson sets it up. So a 1-0 Cleveland lead here in the first period. And the Jacks hold on. They played a Muskegon as the Lumberjacks and moved on this season here to Richfield. Here's the play on left wing, and the Jacks on the attack. Here's Mikhailik, who's already had 1 point tonight. Into the far side for the of forward Duberman along the far side. Trying to center one, does, but blocked off at the defense. Mikhailuk is still the leading scorer for the Lumberjacks and has had seven consecutive 100-point seasons. And here is Mikhailuk at center. Arches into the Salt Lake zone. Trying to drop it free, succeeds to the player cutting in, Paul Dick, trying to dump it in front, and Priestley now back to the goal. Trying to center one, does, and the save by Kidd, and Paul Cruz able to cue it all the way down deep into Cleveland territory.
Excellent job once again. Trevor Kidd making the initial save, and the solid Golden Eagle defenseman pounce on that puck and ice it right down. Good job.
Here is Jamie Huard on right wing. Huard out of Regina, the Western Hockey League. Skies it right back into the Salt Lake zone. The Eagles clear it away for Tim Harris. Harris just picks an opening, winds but not out. Here is Peter Ahola, able to hold it in, the former Phoenix Roadrunner. Back to the right wing point. Huard a shot, and Kidd steers it aside. Up Priestley, his shot, Kidd, a save. Loose in front of the goal. And finally cleared for Gillingham as the Eagles have killed off the penalty. And here's Sean Hafey to center, skies it right back in. Hafey hot for Salt Lake with a total of goals in four straight games. The Eagles deep in a forecheck. Gillingham effort on his knees, then tries to bump down a Cleveland player, but the Jacks break back on left wing. And finally wound free on the opposite side for Sandy Smith, who dumps it right back into the Salt Lake zone. Golden Eagles down 1-0 here against the Cleveland Lumberjacks in the first meeting this season, and a two-line offside from inside the Salt Lake blue line to the Cleveland side of center. 15:36 to go in the opening period. 1-0 Lumberjacks. And Kerry Clark having some words with one of the linesmen. And Phil Russell, 40 years of age, from Edmonton, Alberta, 15 years in the NHL.
They've been called the Big Bad Golden Eagles, but maybe not for long. This year, the National and International Hockey Leagues have instituted several new rules to crack down on unnecessary roughness and fighting, including severe penalties for slashing and high-sticking violations. More important, any instigator of a fight will be automatically ejected, and although fighting is still allowed, slowly but surely it is being eliminated.
Because it's getting to be Americanized, where people down here don't know the game, they don't understand why there's fighting or something like that, and why there's tough play. They have to change the game so they understand it. They don't take the time enough to learn it. And they're just turning into like Hockey Hollywood or something like that, where they want to, they say they want to sell the product, and actually you're getting people leaving the rinks because of taking out fighting.
Here in Salt Lake City and throughout the United States, hockey has been criticized for allowing fighting and not appealing to the average family. The National Hockey League has been reluctant to completely ban fighting, fearing it will hurt attendance. Golden Eagle fans, for the most part, seem not to mind.
I enjoy a good fight every now and then, but I don't like them to get real violent where someone gets hurt.
Well, yeah, I think it's exciting just to see them fight and watch them, watch the thing up on the Jumbotron, how they show the fighting stuff and stuff. I think it's okay.
The physical part of the game is very important in hockey. A lot of the advantages of the team gains over another one is how physically they play.
Some fans prefer the skating and shooting to the punching and banging.
We don't come for the fighting. We definitely come for the skating, for the game.
I don't like them personally. You know, I just wish they wouldn't have them.
I don't really like to see it in hockey, but it's acceptable.
Regardless, the rules are changing, and the transition for players has been difficult. Eagles player Paul Cruz believes fighting is part of hockey for a reason.
But it's always been part of the game. You know, if you don't have fighting, you're going to have high sticking. You're going to have more stick infractions. You're going to have the smaller players skating around, sticking players in the face and getting away with it.
Whatever the reason, some players feel that fights often have more bark than bite.
I'd rather see a good fist to cuff. It lasts a minute and it's over. Everybody skates away. The battle's done, and the fans got a good rush where they're cheering for their player that they want to win the fight. And the players don't really get hurt too much. Maybe a pride a little bit if they get knocked down.
While fighting continues in the sport of hockey, the vast majority of hockey fans still prefer the skating and scoring skills of a Rich Chernomaz rather than the punching and beating that has characterized hockey in the past.
Well, I think that's what the biggest problem has been, is that people relate hockey to fighting right away, and once they come a couple times and realize the skill and the finesse that's involved, and they learn to appreciate more what the players are doing rather than just reading the paper and seeing two guys dropping their gloves in the newspaper clipping.
Saturdays, nor any other night, might not be all right, as fighting in hockey slowly fades as an important part of hockey's tradition.